The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjit. You're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back to my channel. And today we are going to talk about your lungs, right? How can you keep your lungs healthy? Seven best, top and most important ways in which you are damaging your hair, your lungs, and how can you prevent this damage. So we are going to talk about your lungs. These are professional tips, pro tips for your lungs. Hindi mein ye video already hai, Hindi version is already present in this same channel. You can just type lungs and doctor education together on YouTube and you'll find the Hindi video as well as the English as well, right? So what is this professional tricks? What are the tips? How do you damage your lungs, right? The number one reason why you end up damaging your lungs actually is smoking. Everyone knows, right? Smoking damages your lungs. Smoking deposits all that bad coal tar like stuff into your lungs, but it has many more bad chemicals. More than 7,000 chemicals are found in the actual tobacco smoke, and out of the 7,000, more than 700 are carcinogenic. So cancers, lung fibrosis, tumors, lung bronchospasm, bronchitis, COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disorder, these are all medical terms, but technically, these are all lung diseases, right? Lung diseases which prevent proper exchange of air, meaning exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide inside your lungs, happening because of smoking. Number one reason, smoking. Number two reason, which is actually a little more further or bigger than smoking, is passive smoking, secondary smoking. Yes, it's a big issue because people don't realize that the secondhand smoke which they are inhaling from their friends, from their friend circle, even if they are not smoking, is worse. Yes, it is worse than smoking and it's not good for you. That's why it's banned to smoke in public places and you have to take a stand and avoid being at a place where people are smoking, or avoid those companies which are, right, who smoke. Then the third big reason is actually air pollution, outdoor air pollution. Yes, air pollution is a big problem because there are a lot of people who are exposed to unnecessary air temperatures, higher temperature of air, dust, smoke, fog, smog, ozone, right? And the petrochemicals which are burned in your vehicles, right? So the most amount of air pollution is in the traffic, during the traffic on the road. So if you are on the road, you are exposed to these chemicals, these pollutants. Air pollution going inside your lungs can damage and can be very similar to smoking. So it's not good for you. Then if there is actual pesticide exposure, if you are working in a farm, if you are using pesticides in your lawn, your garden, so these pesticides are also one potential source of lung problem, right? So all the outside bad stuff, right, burning stuff outside in the air, open air, that is also wrong, which happens in India, unfortunately. But what can you do? The government or you can take a stand. That's what you can do, right? And then fourth problem are infections, right? Everyone has lung infections. Once in a while, everyone has some sort of cold, flu, right, fever. So our problem is either we ignore these symptoms, either we don't do anything, or we, in India, mostly people go to the chemist and take medicines from them, and in 2-3 antibiotic dosages they get little better, and they don't realize that not completing the whole antibiotic course, they are basically increasing the resistance of that bacteria, and ultimately in future they or their children will suffer from a more dangerous type of bacteria which will not respond to medicines. That is one big issue. And if you're not taking care of your infections, then ultimately your lung is suffering and over time it becomes injured. So that is one thing. So what can you do? Number one, you have to avoid crowds, because crowded places are number one causes of spreading airborne diseases, right? Anyone in the crowd has flu, has cold cough, they can actually just sneeze there and it can spread to many people. So avoid crowded places and wash your hands, because if you have cold or you are touching some surface and somebody has sneezed on it or some kind of particles are there, you can just very easily touch it and then you can infect yourself, inoculate yourself. That is one big issue. Then keeping a good oral hygiene is important, and it's very important that if you are sick, then you don't have to get out of the house, stay inside, get well soon and then go out, don't spread the disease. So it's very important to prevent infections on the first place, either it's your or others' infections. So it's, this is the point. And then another point is health checkups. It's very important to get yourselves checked every year or twice or every 2 years. It's important to get yourself checked. And no matter what is your age, you should get yourself checked. After a certain age, obviously it should be increased to yearly or half yearly. So that is one important thing. And then you have to understand, one more thing was left in outside pollution: construction workers, mining places. If you are working near that place or you're working in that place itself, then there is a big health risk. Not just of those things falling on your head and you have to wear all those sorts of headgears and gowns and etc., protective gear, but there is a big risk of the dust particles going inside your lungs, right? So you have to take care of them also. Wear masks if possible, right? And the sixth thing is actually exercise. Yes, exercise is the biggest and the best thing which you can do for your lungs, not just lungs but all body. Right. So if you, when you exercise, you basically increase the blood circulation as well as the elasticity of your lungs, as well as the air entry, oxygen exchange, the capacity, the vital capacity, etc., etc. Everything increases of your lungs. So your lungs can actually start to heal just by exercise. It's very good. Exercise, regular exercise, no matter if it is 5, 10, 15 minutes, 1 hour, doesn't matter. Right, but you have to incorporate some exercise. It doesn't have to be outside the house. It doesn't have to be a very big exercise. It can be just on the bed, just on the floor. It can be anything, right? It just needs to be a little challenging. That's the most important thing, little challenging, okay? So exercise. Then what is important? Inside the house. Inside the house also there are problems. What problems? Inside the house, if there is a lot of moisture, there will be more bacteria, more viruses going around in the house. So you have to control moisture in the house, and you have to maintain the home appliances for that, or even for that matter, home appliances like a furnace or an air conditioner. These things can have molds and other kind of infective fungi or aspergillosis, kind of an infective thing, breeding inside them, and then they can infect you. That is also bad for your lungs. So you have to take care of these home for these appliances. Then you have to clean the surfaces at home. Obviously, everybody does this. Controlling dust is important. Ventilation is very important in the house. Many times nowadays, ventilation is a problem. So proper ventilation is important for proper, air in the house. This is most important. And the final, if I say one big thing which is required for you to do for your lungs, then what is it? What is it? Right? It's deep breathing. Yes, when you breathe deeply. Now I'm not talking about fast breathing. Fast breathing is a different thing. That is fast breathing. We're deep breathing. Take it inside and wait. That's how you breathe. Deep breathing. It's very important. Whenever you find fresh air or you find a greenery, green area, then if you're outside, then it's very important that you breathe deeply. That's a good exercise for your lungs. If you follow all these things, avoid these bad stuff, then you're going to have a good lung all of your life, and you can prevent lung diseases. Stop smoking. You can just go through all the points and make sure to follow them. Make sure to subscribe, hit the bell icon, make sure to share this video. I'm Dr. Paramjit. You're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected and stay healthy.